We have with us Gibo Teodoro, and joining us is his wife, former Talak Representative Monica Prieto-Teodoro, or people call her Nikki. So good morning to you, both Gibo and Nikki. Good morning.
Good morning. Good morning. Karen, nice to see you.
Okay.
It's been a while.
I know. Well, for Gibo, it's been 10 years since I last covered him. But I wanted to ask first, he says you were the most influential voice in making him or encouraging him to run again.
Did you say that? Oh, okay.
He did. So where did it come from? Why did you, what did you tell him, and why did you suddenly?
Karen, I don't know if you know this, but I represent the Philippines in the for UNICEF.
Yes, yes.
For this country, I actually take care of the children through UNICEF in the UN. I speak on behalf of this country for the president, actually. And my passion since 2007 are to take care of children, the welfare of children. And I founded the Committee on the Welfare of Children in 2007, and now it's a standing committee. And ever since 2007, I haven't stopped taking care of children. And then when the president appointed me as his representative for the UNICEF, I gladly accepted. And I've had the position since 2017.
Yes, but so why did I ask you?
Because yes. I felt that Gilbert and I could give more back. Mm-hmm. I mean, the online pornography is up almost 400% mm-hmm. because of the lockdown. Okay. And I was telling Gilbert, with our expertise and we work so well together and people have been calling you back, this is the time to do it, mm-hmm. And he's had the 10-year break that he needed. He's been mm-hmm. in politics since, 15? So, he needed a break, and he didn't want to be, so involved that it kind of took away from Gilbert. Mm-hmm. Gilbert's a very wholesome person, Okay,
right.
So, being in politics, sometimes, you get lost.
Okay, but did Gibo say, what are you thinking? I have been out for 10 years. He couldn't have just said yes.
It was a process. It started maybe the beginning of the pandemic. Like maybe February, we were abroad and we kind of got stuck there. And we were like, my gosh, what's happening? And we thought in 2 months, Karen, we thought we'd be back here. Mm. And it just took longer.
Nikki Gibo, why the vice presidency?
Because Gilbert's been out of the limelight for so long. You can't just jump in like that. Mm. But the thing, what got us was that Mayor Sarah and I have such strong ties for children. And when I got there, when I went with Gilbert and Congressman Andaya, it was just so obvious, when we started to talk, because actually Sarah and I had a long talk, maybe almost as long as Gilbert and her.
I see. So you were there in Davao.
Yeah,
You were not in the photos.
Asked me everything about what are you doing, what keeps you busy, and then we opened up about
me. Did she categorically at least say that she was running for the presidency? Gibo wouldn't say, just said, if she announces, I'll support her, but did she discuss it?
Karen, it's hard to say that it's, a done deal, because we have to think about what we're going to do and what Gilbert and Sarah are going to do as a team. They have to plan it very well if they decide that they are the tandem. And they're apparently running independent. That's so totally new. Mm-mm. And it's a total change, and it's so refreshing.
But I think what's important here is the idea of the tandem itself. People are asking, did Congressman Andaya, make this up, so to speak, as a PR ploy?
In all fairness, he did not. He did not. We went there just to talk, mm-hmm. and it just got, Nonoy kept eating and eating and eating. I said, Nonoy, that's like your fifth meal already. We're there that long. I didn't even eat because I was talking to Mayor Sarah for so long that I didn't even eat.
Yeah. And, so how did the tandem come up? Gibo said...
Similarities in what they want to do, how they want to do it, how they want to approach it. And the fact that, Gilbert has been out of the limelight 10 years being...
Actually, also, Nonoy Andaya wanted this meeting because he really felt it in his heart that both Mayor Sara and I could do something together for the country. Mm. And it comes from his heart.
So he saw you as the best partner for Sara.
Oh, definitely. Okay. Definitely. It's undeniable from Congressman Andaya's statements. And we've worked together for a long time.
And I was close to Marisa. I mean, his wife, his late wife, was a good friend of mine.
We were freshmen together. Our parents, my mother and his father, were colleagues in the Constitutional Convention. Mm. And we were freshmen together. And in our second term, even though we were not party mates, he was the choice of our party then to be the chairman of the Appropriations Committee.
Okay. All right.
So we worked together very, very closely.
So you're very close, clearly. Now, moving forward, the passing of business tycoon Danding Cuanco, of course, he had, frankly, a big impact in politics in choosing who to support. I mean, he also had strong grassroots connection with his party. How does the passing affect you, Gibo, in wanting to come back to politics in 2020?
For me, wanting to come back is because this is a changed world. It started December 2019, but, you know, everybody discounted it.
Yeah.
Then March, come lock down the whole world. This is a changed world. And the specter of, you know, poor people really in caskets in India, to billionaires waiting for hospital rooms in our country, it is a great equalizer.
Yes.
I get you
he
there.
He doesn't choose anybody.
Exactly.
I get you there. But let's go back to my question.
You have a calling.
Yeah, one.
You have a calling to do your best.
But
try to help the country, and it so happened, and that happened.
Okay, but going back to my question first, I get the importance of really how COVID has changed our lives. That's quite clear. But politically speaking, locally, maybe Nikki, does Danding Cuanco's passing, does it leave a void in terms of grassroots connection, even funding, even influence, even that kind of impact if Gibo runs for 2022? Or frankly, do you feel it's quite freeing?
Well, all of the above, actually. All the things you've said is correct. It is quite freeing, but Tito Danding had a big impact, as we all know. And he has left a legacy. So yeah, it's all of the above. But the thing is, Gilbert has always been independent, as you know, Karen. I mean, you covered us during 2010, and you know it was all separate from family.
On the other hand, Karen, we have to admit also that the political dynamic has changed. There's a new set of leaders, a new set of voters, actually. And the divide between X and Y position has been so big.
Yes.
So you need to close that gap, to close that divide in order to help the country.
Okay.
It is not a time for sniping anymore or whatever.
Okay. So I don't have enough time, but I want to close with this. If you succeed, this would be considered as one of the biggest comebacks of all time in local politics, frankly, right? Considering that you had lost 2010, and then you had a 10-year out of the limelight life, and then suddenly the possible comeback is the second highest position in the land, which is a step away from the presidency. How do you believe you would wing this and make it happen? Of course, the Sara Duterte choosing you is the biggest thing there. But if you don't have a political party, so yan ang tanong ko, Nikki has been in Congress, how would you do it? If you won't join PDP Laban, how would you win?
you know, Karen, we need everything.
You know what?
I think we lost.
Yeah, your internet.
I think, Karen, it's now the power.
Yeah, it's the internet.
That's why connectivity and digital hardening, when we talk about OPNC, digital hardening and hardening, what's the importance? Information directly to people. People have more access to information right now. And I think that is also a great equalizer.
All right. On that note, I do hope your internet
people can have out the Philippines.
Okay. It's so sad because we're losing you.
Yes.
Yes.
Okay, I guess Gibo, just to close, can you give a last message? Oh, all right. Now they've disappeared. Okay, so that is Head Start. Oh, there, he's back. It just quickly, since this is your first interview after 10 years, Gibo, can you give I guess your last message? What are you waiting for at this point? Okay, do you have a message to Sarah, Gibo?
No, I wish that I read her statements the other day. She's really concentrated on managing the COVID and Davao. So I wish that she's successful in her.
Okay. You all see, right.
I think
you
I
get all that, Karen.
This is all right. So, well, first, I want to thank Gibo and Nikki for joining us this morning. At least we had a very, very good portion where the internet was still working well. So thank you for that. And I do hope to speak with you again, Gilbert Teodoro, of course, once things start to pan out more concretely, then we can get a better update of things to come. Thank you.